Good morning. My name is Catherine Whittier, and I am a senior Dominican preacher. The main theme in today's gospel is humility. Humility is defined by dictionary.com as a modest or low view of one's own importance or the act of being humble. I tried really hard to think of different examples of humility in the world that I could talk about today, and this is what I came up with. The first example is me. I'm just kidding. The actual first and obvious example is Mother Teresa. A famous quote of hers says, "Humility is the mother of all virtues, purity, charity, and obedience. It is being humble that our love becomes real, devout, and ardent. If you are humble, nothing will touch you, neither praise nor disgrace, because you know what you are. If you are blamed, you will not be discouraged. If they call you a saint, you will not put yourself on a pedestal." This quote of hers is thought-provoking, and I found the longer I thought about it, the more certain I became. Good deeds matter, but it doesn't matter who you do them for and who sees you do it. Everyone has faced a choice in their lives before that forces them to choose between humility and fame. Maybe someone asked what you got on a test, and you know you got the highest grade. Do you own your score, letting everyone know you got the 100, or do you downplay it? Do you say you got a good grade, or just not tell anyone? What's the right choice? Another general example is a parent. From birth, babies are born defenseless, helpless, and entirely dependent on their parents. And a good parent never once brags about how well they raised their child. But having a child turn out so much more mature than the one whose diapers they changed or noses they wiped can be the best example of humility and love rolled into one. The next example is a bit of a weird one, but I think it relates in a different way. Tim Cook, the CEO of Apple, lives his life much like any of us, despite making millions of dollars every year. He said, "I like to be reminded of where I came from, and putting myself in modest surroundings helps me to do that. Money is not a motivation for me." His morning routine is waking up at 4 a.m., spending an hour on email, then going to the gym, all of which are completely modest things to do. So maybe he is humble in the way he lives, but it doesn't make it more humble for him sharing it. Another different example comes from the Bible itself. Luke chapter 20, verse 45 to chapter 21, verse 14 shows Jesus preaching to his disciples. Jesus says, "Beware of the teachers of the law. They like to walk around in flowing robes and love to be treated in the marketplaces and have the most important seats in the synagogue and the places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses and make for a show of lengthy prayers. Such men will be punished most severely." Then Jesus looked over and saw a poor widow offering two small coins into a collection bin. Next to her was a rich man who offered a multitude of coins with everyone watching and praising him. The widow quietly left, while the man stayed and accepted all of the blessings. Who was more humble? Who was a better representative of humility? Reflecting back on all four examples, five if you count me, of humility, I ask you again, who was more humble? Is it Mother Teresa, who taught us how to love, how to be loved, and how to be humble? Could it be the tirelessly working parent who raised their child but never once bragged about how well they did it? Or was it Tim Cook, who showed everyone how humble he is, who made it a point to show how humble he is in his everyday life? Or is it the poor widow, who gave her only small offering, knowing it was enough? In truth, very few of these examples encompass the meaning of humility because they all portray themselves as humble. But I'll let you be the judge of that. Thank you.